nervous.
You're saying Olivia's a massive diva. I knew it.
Oh, in terms of that, Colin.
Look around you. This whole place is for people who want to escape. People who don't belong anywhere else.
Well, it's lovely to talk to you both about Empire of Light. Thank you for making me an emotional wreck.
Yay. You're welcome.
I was just sobbing, not pretty crying, like ugly tears.
Oh, good. That's what we want.
The film really celebrates the power of cinema. What's the most memorable cinematic experience that you guys have had?
One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. I'll never forget the first time I saw that. It was amazing.
Do you want to say something to the group, Mr. McMurphy?
And Breaking the Waves for me, I saw when I was at drama school, and that's when I knew that I wanted to do work like her.
I think for me, it's definitely a dance film, so I'd just go for Step Up to the Streets. I remember going there like on non-school uniform day with a lot of my friends. It was like our thing, we'd go to cinema all the time. But I just remember this one in particular, like, you know, because we all came out and we was all like trying to basically be one of the dancers in the thing, literally walking out of the cinema all the way home, like even on the bus, everything. So yeah, I'd say Step Up to the Streets.
I didn't expect that one, but that's a strong choice.
Yeah, it's a great film.
Hillary encourages Stephen to follow his dream of being an architect. And I imagine for you guys, you're both living out your dreams of being actors. Is there anything on the acting bucket list that you'd love to tick off that you haven't already? Aside from more junkets with me, of course.
That's
ticked. Yes.
I've always wanted to walk in slow motion with a car exploding behind me. And my husband wrote a little scene in Landscapers, which almost had that. But I've always wanted to, yeah, be a badass. But walking in slow motion and not flinching as this thing goes...
I'd love to see that.
Yeah, me too.
More badass Olivia Colman.
You know what?
Do you want to do that too?
No, I do want to do that. But I wouldn't say it's my... But if I didn't do it by the end of my career, I wouldn't cry about it. I want to ride a horse in a movie.
Oh, that'll definitely happen.
Can you ride a horse?
No.
Nah.
I'm scared of animals. But that's why I want to be able to do it one day and say I had done this in my career.
Because I've heard that's what a lot of actors lie about, the fact that they can horse ride.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I don't know why.
So you actually need to say, no, I can horse ride now. We don't want anyone listening to this thinking that you can't.
Everyone can learn. Everyone learns from starts from somewhere, right?
Yeah. Exactly. Well, you should maybe just do some secret lessons. I'd recommend someone.
You do horse riding?
I've had to for films, and I was scared of horses.
Yeah.
And the Devil's Horsemen, this is a company that do lots of films and television. Yeah. But their horses are so gentle and so beautifully... They just know.
And gentle.
They give you a sort of horse like a sofa if you're a nervous person.
Yeah.
And you get on, and the horse goes, ugh. And when you're going round in the little paddock, he's always trying to get back to his stable to eat an apple. He doesn't really want to, and it's so gentle.
Yeah.
Sorry, talking too much, but that's, I'll recommend.
Michael, we found your perfect instructor.
Exactly.
You don't need, Olivia, you don't need to give him a number.
But you need to be there.
I'll come.
Come for moral support.
Exactly, I need that.
But speaking of dreams, do you guys remember the moment that you landed your first dream role and how that felt?
Yes, it was very recent. For me, it was Top Boy, and obviously playing Jamie and that. Like, being a lead character on a show that I was a fan of when I was a kid, for me, that was, like, absurd, you know? And the feeling was quite... It was... Every day felt unbelievable, like, because every... You know, one day you're doing something and the next day you're on set with Ashley, so that was unbelievable. Then the next day, like, you're shooting guns, like, that's unbelievable. Then the next day, you're like, you know what I'm trying to say? Everything was something, like, all the way to the end of the process. And then the post bit of that, you know, the film coming out, the series coming out and stuff like that, you know. For me, it was just, every day was just an unbelievable day.
Jamie, yeah?
But yeah, it was great.
It's an incredible series. How about for you, Olivia?
When I got the part for Tyrannosaur and Paddy Considine, I think that changed my life, that film. And... at the time, it's been seen since, but at the time, not many people saw it, and that was slight heartbreak.
What have you done, girl?
What? But that was an incredible job that someone gave me a chance that saw something in me, because I'd done comedy up till then, Paddy.
And then that changed the tide. Yeah. Amazing. I need to see it.
It's quite sad.
We like sad.
But it's also uplifting. It's sort of beautiful.
Nice.
You really are incredible in it, Michael. You've got to see it. That's next on the list. I love the moment when Hillary gets up at the premiere to say a few words in this. And it kind of reminded me, it got me thinking that it must feel that way when you're accepting awards and you have to get up on stage and speak to a whole room of lots of famous people. What goes through your head in that moment?
What did you feel?
For me, there was just a lot of things that could go wrong in my head. So I kept thinking I was going to trip up the stairs.
Yeah.
And then once I got through that, I was like, cool, I might drop the award. So, but then when Daniel, because obviously Daniel handed me my award, Daniel Kaluuya, and when he gave me a hug, he said something in my ear, and I was like, yes! Okay, so then I just felt a lot more confident. And then when I was like being able to do my speech, it was just that I just don't want to cry. But yeah, it was just a great feeling, you know what I'm saying? And, but speaking in front of a group of people, I just wanted to get my last message out, you know, which was that a lot of, you know, people like me, a lot of black people, young boys and girls, you know, just need to see opportunities. That's just what, that was like my main focus, to try to get that message out there, because I know it would be something that they would see. So yeah.
I've got to ask, what did Daniel whisper in your ear?
I don't quite remember, actually. I just remember it was just like, nah, this is your moment. Just be like, something like, be strong. Like, he knew, he could see that I was nervous, innit? I mean, anyone could see that I was nervous in that moment. But yeah, it was great, and it really helped me.
Yeah.
How about for you, Olivia? What goes through your head?
Well, not much. Similar sort of, don't trip over.
Yeah.
Don't
embarrass yourself.
Don't snot. Imagine doing a speech with, no, just all of those things, the worst things that could happen. Have I got cabbage in my teeth?
All the stuff that
But I kept telling myself, it's a room, when it's a room of actors, I think, unless I'm really naive, but actors are really supportive of each other, and they know that feeling of being on stage and being nervous. So they are, I think they're really there with you.
Yeah.
So to try and it's a room full of friends, really. It's just the cameras with the other people who you don't know.
Yeah.
But it's terrifying. You can't really remember what happened until you have to watch it back and then go, oh, okay, yeah. Didn't have cabbage in my teeth.
Lady Gaga.
Well, your Gaga moment is just iconic. It's the best thing that's ever happened. I stand by that. Speaking of awards, Michael, I've got to ask, who has bigger Oscar winner energy, Olivia or Colin?
Oscar winner
I'm
energy.
Right here.
What do you mean by that?
You're saying Olivia is a massive diva. I knew it.
In terms of that, Colin.
Phil. It's just static frames with darkness in between.
The way that Norman lights up when he's working in the cinema made me feel so warm. When did you guys first have those feelings about acting?
Oh, wow.
You're asking some really amazing questions.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
I feel like when I really started having those feelings about acting is when I started having characters that I could actually speak. That, you know, when you first, like, get in, you're like, oh, you know, this is quite weird. Like, and that, and you can hear it back. I was like, oh, yeah, now I can actually see myself as someone. Because, like, up until the point I got, like, you know, roles where I'd speak, it was that, like, I'd done music videos and, like, you know, extra roles and stuff like that. And, you know, you'd always, like, try to just see yourself. But it's not really, you know, I feel like voice is very important in terms of acting anyway. So that's when I started feeling like I'm really doing something here. You know what I mean? And obviously that feeling changes over time. But yeah, that those initial stages when I first got to speak and hear myself on like while I'm watching myself, that was amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I did my first school play I did when I was 16. And it was the first moment when I could do something. I was so rubbish at school. And suddenly I thought, oh, no, I really love this. I wonder if there's a job that involves doing this. So from 16, I think I fell in love with it.
Well, you're both very good at it.
Thanks.
Thank you so much for talking to me, and huge congrats on the film. I loved it. And thank you for always being so kind to me, both of you.
Oh,
always such
lovely.
A pleasure to chat to.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Hits Radio.